Good afternoon, my friends. Thank you for joining me. Here's an update what's going on there in the Canary Islands, the island of La Palma. There has been 19 earthquakes within the last 24 hours. A definite uptick in the amount of earthquakes, and they've been deep, which is concerning because they're within the lower magma chamber of this caldera. The largest being a magnitude 3.8, which they downgraded to a magnitude 3.6. Seven of them within the last 24 hours, last day, have been over a magnitude 3. We got a 3.4, 3.6, 3.2, another 3.2. And then down here, which actually was on the 30th, a 3.5. and a 3.4 and a 3.0. Here we have an image from Reuters of the magma. Another vent opened up on the side of the main cinder cone. It has collapsed several times and regrown. And 800 buildings, homes and businesses, churches and schools so far have been destroyed. Residents of Los Anos de Ardane, one of the worst affected towns, have taken to carrying umbrellas and wearing eye protection as a precaution against the volcanic dust that is blanketing the streets and floating in the air. Cumbre Vieja volcano is now carving a different path from the previous flows and is raising fears that more destruction will come. The fine ash now is forcing islanders to wear masks and goggles, not sunglasses, but regular respiratory masks. Here's an image of some of the ash and what they call lapilli, which is small fragments of rocks. This has been found falling in the small town of Tucuya. I'll show you on Google Earth where that's at. Here I mapped out some of the areas of the lava flows, and we'll go to that city where this image was photographed from. There you go, right there. If you get enough of that, this stuff can collapse the roofs of buildings. This area is more than 2 miles from the volcano cone. 4 inches of ash, or 100 millimeters, can take out the roof of a building. Wet ash has twice the weight as dry ash. 4 inches of dry ash, that's all it takes to make the roof of a building collapse. It can damage electronics, such as keyboards for computers. Moisture in the air making the ash wet can cause the computers and electronics to arch and short out. It is severe to crops if it's more than 4 to 6 inches, 100 to 150 millimeters. It's also very harmful for the animals that breathe it in. Ash affects the smaller animals because they have smaller lung capacity quicker than it does for larger animals. Birds would be the first animals affected by the ash. Yeah, people there in La Palma have already been taking action, and they've been sweeping this ash off the roofs. Like I said, only 4 inches could make it collapse. If it rains, it's only 2 inches, and it can make their roofs collapse. So a good thing that some of these people are out there sweeping off the roofs. Here on IGN is one of the earthquakes that brought out the hot magma. You see the earthquakes. We got two right there. We got another one. Now this is between 16 and 1700 hours. That would be universal time. And this is what it's been showing for the last hour. There was also a video, and I'll give you a link to this, of some geologists behind a block wall or part of what's left of a house. I don't know if they were taking gas readings or what, but they were out there when there was an explosion there at the summit, at the cone, and it threw rock and debris. I don't know if you can see this. I'll make it bigger. They quickly ducked underneath the wall. There's one of the rocks. I mean, look how large it is compared to his head. And people were asking, why were they wearing shorts and short sleeve shirts? Supposedly, the reason was because if their clothing caught on fire, they could quickly remove it easier from their skin. Here you can see the ash, the large pieces of, you know, that rock on the clothing. And I don't know if you can see right here, but they're not wearing cloth masks. They are wearing respirators. There, maybe you can see it better. And there is another image of the large pieces of pumice rock being thrown over the wall at these two geologists. Here's another image of one of the new lava vents that opened up. And here you can see, yeah, there's no roof left of that house. And the one next to it that burned up, let me bring this down a little bit. Yeah, see how you can still see the indentation of where the lava went before it burned up. And again, this is the one where the roof collapsed. And another image of the lava, two different streams that flowed into one, ended up being one. And to give you an idea how fast this lava was flowing, let me turn this on for a second. Yeah, it was flowing really fast. And another still capture what is going on with the cone. You can see here part of it collapsed, the front blew out. We have another vent right in this area here. And we got these two vents here and of course on the other side. And what is also concerning is this whole cone has been steaming. So it's getting water from somewhere. And the scientists are worried that they're going to have another collapse or a explosion, a pyroclastic flow. Supposedly, on the north side, they've been recording multiple small explosions underneath the cone. But yeah, it could collapse and then rebuild and yeah, collapse again. But the water getting down into the side of Cumbe Vieje, yeah, that's a little concerning. And there's another video showing the lava that's extending way out into the ocean. I believe this is from yesterday. And there's an aerial view of this lava. Yeah, it's extended quite a ways out into the ocean now. And like I said, it's going to be killing all sea life in that area. I have not seen or heard any reports about dead fish washing up, but you know that's happening. Yeah, dead crabs and lots of other poor sea life. So I appreciate you guys hanging out with me and giving you the latest of the updates for what's going on. Please thumbs up my videos. Thank you for sharing. And I send prayers to all the people on the island and to all my friends that are watching. Thank you very much. And I will make another video soon. Please stay safe and God bless you all. Bye.